Jersey Nets losing Tuesday to the NBA champion Pistons by 9, beginning start with Jason Kidd and Rodney Buford, Nenad Krstić, a rookie, Vince Carter, and Jason Collins. The Houston Rockets, Jason Kidd to Rodney Buford. Collins to Vince Carter, into Kidd, nice ball rotation to Collins, nice rebound by Buford.
Those are the kind of easy scores that New Jersey's going to have to get. This is a team, then you can go to your bench. New Jersey, when they go to the bench, they have to play from the hip. You can see right there, New Jersey, they're what they've done when they were a great team. They won 76% of the first quarters, always got off to great starts, and they're off to a good start here tonight.
Rodney Buford cans one. He's out of Creighton in his fifth NBA season. He's got five. Buford, who was initially selected in the NBA by the Miami Heat. And now New Jersey is plus three in rebounding. Carter, Buford. Of course, they're playing without Richard Jefferson as Vince Carter knocks it in. He's been bad 10 games as a starter. He has led him in scoring five of the nine that he's already played.
Energy right now. New Jersey's a pressure team. They're playing shorthanded. They're off to a great lead. And Jeff Van Gundy's got to get his team inspired to play.
And the Nets are 3.5 games out of that eighth and final Eastern Conference playoff slot. Juwan Howard, rebound by Rodney Buford. The two best players on this team are Yao and McGrady.
And very quiet, you know, sort of unassuming guys. Great, great talents. Another turnover. This is a comedy of errors right now.
Air ball by Vince Carter. They've got a couple trade exceptions. $10 million trade exception, a $5 million trade exception.
Picked up by Ben.
Now, Krstić had an open shot and dribbled the ball. When he did, he took a tough one. Here's Jason Kidd with a great steal. Watch his pass.
Oh, to Buford, and an accolade by McGrady. And a foul called on Tracy McGrady for the first time tonight. What a pass by Kidd, you called it.
Well, he plays the game with a rearview mirror. He sees what's happening behind him. He's like, he's unbelievable. I mean, look at him. He's got his eyes on the target. But yet he knows there's a man right behind him. He knows McGrady's a shot blocker. So he sets him up and he gets the foul. How unselfish play by Jason Kidd. He could have gone in there and maybe drawn the foul himself.
So here's Buford at the line. These are the first free throws of the game. Now, Rodney Buford is replacing Richard Jefferson, and we know that Jefferson's injury, a ruptured ligament in his left wrist, now 3 to 4 months. Ron Mercer, when he comes back, will probably take the place of Jefferson, but when they lose Jefferson, they lose their number one scorer, their number one rebounder, their number one assist man, and only Kevin Garnett.
So the starters now, when they come back in, are going to have to come back in with some energy.
Jabari Smith comes in for the first time for the New Jersey Nets. There's a foul, and it goes on a pick and a screen set by Dikembe Mutombo. Remember, Yao's on the bench already with two fouls. Here's Bowen. He's another high-energy player. Yao being handcuffed inside.
I don't know why he's using that dribble. All he has to do is turn around and shoot the basketball.
8 points for Nenad Krstić of New Jersey. Carter is 2 of 7, and 7 points by Tracy McGrady so far. Nice outside three, nailed by Buford, who's got a game-high 10.
Kevin, he's had stretches in this league where he can put up points on the board. He was a big-time scorer. It's great. Great.
He was, in fact. Buford had a nice seven-game stretch where he shot almost 60% from the field. 43 to 41. All the reasons why New Jersey has held that lead. The 10 points of fifth-year player Rodney Buford, who is standing by with our Cheryl Miller.
Rodney, this team comes in, obviously, losing Richard Jefferson, the team's leading scorer. And if there's any questions offensively, how you guys will pick it up, you answer the call, Jabari Smith and Krstić.
Well, we have to do it all collectively. We know Richard, you know, he was a big part of our offense. You know, he was a key to our success. We just got to fill in the spots and make up for what, you know, what we're missing when he's out here.
This was a Houston team last night that scored 124 points, shot 61%. You guys were able to come in here early, get off to a good start. Did you like the pace in the first half, and do you continue it in the second?
Yeah, big time. That's what we want to do, come out and jump on them early, because we knew they came, they had a game last night. You know, we rested a couple of days, so we're pretty fresh, and we just want to come out and jump on them.
All right, good luck in the second half. EJ, the Nets getting it done without their team's leading scorer. Let's send it back to you in our Atlantic studio.
One of the reasons is because New Jersey struggles to score points.
And they got it from a couple different sources. Rodney Buford was out of the block early with his defense. The rebound by Tracy McGrady. And we know that New Jersey is plus four in rebounding, and McGrady on the fly with the miss, and Buford with the New Jersey rebound.
And you get others chipping in like you've seen with Buford. He's like a sort of a step slow all season long. He's been slow getting on his rotations. And just a giveaway pass by David West. This team right now is playing about as poorly as they can play.
Houston 1-7 in this third quarter shooting. Pickpocketed by Kidd against Sura and over to Buford. And a foul on Bobby Sura.
You see how unselfish Jason Kidd is. There's a lot of guys who would go in, makes the great steal. He's got the ball in the open court, but he has a great ability. Watch what he does here now. He looks, and he's going to create space. He takes the ball to the left side of the floor because he sees Buford running the right lane. Gave him enough opportunity to make that bounce pass. I'm telling you, I played with a point guard, Maurice Cheeks, who passed the ball like Jason Kidd. Now, he didn't have that kind of ability necessarily in the open court, but he was so unselfish, and he was fun to play with.
Speaking of unselfish, the first place Cleveland Cavaliers take on Los Angeles. Cleveland has won four straight. That is game two. Rockets have gone three of nine, hitting threes. Kidd launching a three. And Jason Kidd has his second three-point hit tonight. He's got 8 points, 12, a game high, or I should say New Jersey high, 12 for Buford.
Who's going to score now for New Jersey? Vince Carter's on the bench. We've seen it's been Buford and it's been Christie.
Tracy McGrady. And Howard along to Buford go after it. To his backcourt, Nate Richmond. Rebound by Buford again, snaring the loose ball. 12 points, 5 rebounds, and a couple of assists for Rodney Buford. From Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Just struggling now to find a way to score a basket.
Sura's got 4 fouls. They have such little margin for him. Kidd inside. And Buford got the assist.
They swung the ball. He slipped right over to the opposite block, caught it, and went right up and shot it. There's no way Jason Kidd can bother a shot if he gets it that close to the basket.
Kidd, Kristich, Collins, caught it, Buford. Oh, Rodney Buford throwing down a sledgehammer and brings the Nets to within 4. He's got a net high 14 points.
I watch Patrick Ewing when Yao gets dunked on like that. I know in Patrick's mind, he said, you got to go there and you got to take that foul. You can't let that young guy come in there and dunk the ball at this time of the game.
New Jersey has now lost 3 in a row.
Well, New Jersey did a lot of great things tonight. They just didn't have enough to win the game. But Lawrence Frank should be very proud of his team. They fought hard to the finish.
Kevin Harlan sends along and sending you to Los Angeles